Okay, 2 hours.
So,
okay.
So it's working now?
I started Zoom all the recording. Yeah.
But you won't see anything. It's really nice, huh?
Well, it's about US, so...
No, okay, it's really nice. Okay, do it like that. Okay, cool.
So
tell me. Let's cross that.
I saw you got a really particular view about the artist you talk about in your movies. For example, I see it looks like you wanna hide them sometimes, because maybe in a shadow, maybe in looking them from behind.
Mm-hmm.
How is this? Why?
Okay. Let me put this like that. I really think that. Let's think about the world in such a way. Today, we have access to so many informations. Okay, due to internet, new technologies, and everything. So, it's really easy to know everything about everything. You know, to see every image of anybody. I think it's a very interesting point of our society nowadays, where we can have an amazing knowledge. But I think there's a counterpoint to that, which is basically the amount of information, in a way kills the imagination of the viewer, of the listener, of the reader. Of anybody, in fact. I really think that we are really losing a certain like poetic approach to the world by using information in such a way. So I guess in my films I sort of like try to deal with this thing of recreating some distance, recreating some mystery, sort of like hiding. At the same time as I show those people, but sort of like I guess it's all about like creating a certain mythology almost, you know, a certain really, as I said, I really like this idea of like the communicative era we are in is very interesting and very positive on many points, but it's also very wrong on a few things, and I think the idea that we have to know everything all the time is pretty wrong, and I think that I like the idea of like recreating some distance and some non-communication in between cultures, in between people. I think it's good when people don't know, and I try to make films where you kind of like struggle with this idea, maybe.
Thank you. And how do you choose your subject? How do you decide to, I saw the Sardinian terrorists,
yes.
I saw Japanese, I think it was a kind of folk singer-song author, how do you choose
them? I guess it's just really my taste and my feeling. I choose those people because, I don't know, something clicked inside me. And I'm not a specialist at all of music or anything. I'm really an amateur, and I don't really know what I'm talking about when I talk about something. And I like this approach again. And so I just react to what I feel, and I don't really trust any idea of genre of music or anything. But I like the beauty of such characters like Tomokawa, like Paolo Angeli, those two films that you saw today. And I think they are very different. Hein? One is like from Sardinia, living in Barcelona, sort of like part of more or less avant-garde experimental music world. While the other one is a Japanese guy, older, 60-something, who never really made any success, who's kind of like isolated. But I think those two guys, like many other of the musicians I met in the past months and years, have something very unique in the approach they have to their creation. and it's not really about like belonging to a genre or to or being of a certain age, or it's just like, it's really like me traveling around the world and basically being interested in like stories of different people and how some characters sort of like create a very unique way to express themselves, I guess.
And how did it all begin?
Well, I guess my mom met my father and they had sex and then I was born. I think that's a lot of the time it's how it began.
Oh,
but what do you mean? What began?
I mean about the a point you decide to tell that story, to find a character to talk about around the world.
Mm-hmm.
Connected to the music.
But I started to film a musician when I was in Paris, like 5 years and a half, 6 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just obsessed with music, but I was not a musician, and I was trying to approach music in my own way. And I found, I guess, that cinema, the use of a camera, was the easiest way for me to get acquainted, to get close, to get friends with musicians. And then I started to make projects with music and cinema, and trying to break the borders, break the barriers, trying to search for like a new for my own expression, for my own style, you know. And then that's it. And then at some point, I also felt the need of like traveling more, leaving Paris behind, and leaving more or less what was often like very rock, folk music, for more for other sounds that I didn't know much. More traditional sometimes, also more popular sometimes, more local, depending on where I am. It's just like, yeah, that's just a very simple way of discovering the world, in fact, you know, making films about people on my way. It's good.
And what's next?
What's next for me?
Yes.
I'm gonna continue traveling for a long time. I've been traveling for 3 years now, and after Milan, I'm going to Indonesia.
Mm-hmm.
for a few months. I'm going to Australia. I'm going to Malaysia. I'm going to Ethiopia, to Madagascar. I just want to go to all those places I've never been. You know, I'm just curious, and I just want to explore them and meet some music. But in always the fact of like filming musicians, portraying those people, is just for me an access to the culture behind. You know, it's never the goal. The goal should never be to make a film. You know, to make a film is always sort of like part of the process, part of the. It's a pretext to know something, to know a place. You know. And to understand a bit more of the culture. So that's it, just a very simple nomadic life, anyway.
That's good.
Thanks.
If you need it. Thank you very much.
My pleasure, man.
Huge pleasure. I think this is. Whoa. Practically it's dark, but it's okay. Vincent,
Mathieu, my name. Ciao.